In this video, I'm going to show you how to run the Google Stadia speed test, as well as show you where to find the Google Stadia requirements so you get a great gaming experience. So check it out. Hey everyone, it's Ken here from Northern Viking Everyday, and if you are new to this channel, we bring you videos on reviews and how-tos, so make sure you click that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. Today we're going to be showing you how to run the Google Stadia speed test. So if you're buying a Google Stadia, you know what kind of connection you're going to get, whether you can run 4K, 1080p, 720p, or you can't run your Google Stadia at all. We're also going to show you where you can find the requirements so you get a great gaming experience. We'll get into that right here shortly. If you are buying a Google Stadia, you're going to want to run these tests and as well use the computer or the device that you're going to be using your Google Stadia with in the location to make sure you're getting the perfect results and the connection you need. So let's jump on over to my computer and show you exactly how this is done. Okay, so we're over here on the Google Stadia support page, and this page as well as the speed test will be linked below in the description. So a couple things I do want to point out for you if you are looking to buy a Stadia. The first one is the minimum speed. So 10 megabits per second is the minimum speed that you need in order to use the Stadia. But if you want to do 4K gaming, you need 35 megabits per second or greater. So I would check that out. And that's why we're going to run the speed test here in a moment. You're also going to be able to look through what some of the hardware requirements are. I'll leave that for you to check out on your own, but I do want to show you this. Now, if you have a capped internet connection, you're only allowed a certain amount of data per month. This is something to take into account. So 4K gaming, you're going to be using about 20 gigabytes per hour. So, or it says up to 20 gigabytes per hour. 1080p, about 12.6 gigabytes per hour on the maximum side, and 720p, 4.5 gigabytes per hour. So that's something to think of if you're capped at 500 gigabytes per month, something like that. You could burn through your internet connection very quickly. So I'll leave this for you to go through. There's all sorts of information on audio as well, but let's get right into the speed test that you run. So that's on my other tab here. I'm just going to open that up and it looks something like this. And again, it talks about the speeds you need for 720p gaming. So let's go ahead and run this, and it talks about MLAB. So it's going to be measuring your internet speed, and it could transfer up to about 40 megabytes is what it's saying. So let's go ahead and click on check now, and it's going to start running that speed test. It can take up to about 30 seconds depending on the speed of your internet. So you can see mine's about half done here, and it slowed right down, and here we go, it's speeding up. I am on a wireless connection here on the other end of the house from our router. So there we go, it's just about done. So I ended up getting a 41.157 megabits per second connection. I just ran this a few minutes ago and I was at about 65. Now, again, I am at the totally other end of the house from our router. So if I go over there, let's go do that. I'll turn this off and go run that again over on the other side so we can see what I get. All right, so I'm back and I ran this right next to the router, but still on a wireless connection, and I got 212.167 megabits per second. So if I want to do 4K and know it's going to be constant, I probably should do my setup right next to the router because that's going to be a great gaming experience there. So again, make sure you run this test where you want to play the game in your home. So I hope this video on the Google Stadia speed test and its requirements did help you out. If it did, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. I'd go ahead and run those tests before picking one up just to make sure you're getting the connection you need. Also, if you're interested in learning about God mode on your Windows computer, I've got a link to that video below. It gives you access to pretty much every setting in one folder. You're gonna wanna check that video out. Also, remember to connect with me on social media. You'll find all those links below. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, take care.